Hello and welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to build a Switch Lite dock with a Raspberry Pi. Stay tuned. I'm sure most of you already know that the Switch Lite can't be docked to the TV. Now, what if I tell you, you can combine the portability of the Switch Lite and the dockability of the regular Switch. All you need is a jailbroken Switch and a Raspberry Pi 4. Up in this video, I will show you the things you can do with your docked Switch Lite, how to install everything on the Pi, and discuss some limitations with this setup. Having just a Switch Lite, I was missing out on a lot of Switch features like playing on TV, of course, and using your Joy-Con for local multiplayer. With this setup I have now, I can play Monster Hunter Rise with my DualShock 4. And if you do want to go out and buy a new controller, or feeling a little bit nostalgic, you can play it Wii U style. I can finally play all those motion games that I've missed out, like 1-2 Switch, with all your friends. Else your right hand will do just fine. So I'm using SysDVR. If you've been looking for a Switch Lite docking solution for quite a while, I'm pretty sure you've come across this. It's available on Windows, Mac, and Linux. Here I am playing on my Windows. But if you want to play it on your TV, I wouldn't say it's an elegant or portable solution. And now you've come to that part of the video where I tell you how it's all done. Number one, of course, you need a Raspberry Pi 4. The one I'm using right here is the 4GB version. I've tested it on a Pi 3 but couldn't get it to run at a playable rate. But do comment below if you did. I'd love to hear from you. After you have your Pi running, there are four steps that you need to do. First of all, you need an OS for the Pi. I'm using Gen 2 64 Lite. I've tested a bunch of OSs for this video, and I found Gen 2 64 to include most things you need to get SysDVR running. The least amount of hassles and the least amount of things that you need to install. Once you have Gen 2 64 up and running, step number two is to compile your own SDL2, following the tutorial here. All links will be included down below. Step number three is to install .NET 5.0. Pick the ARM64 version for Linux. Follow the instructions here to install. And the final step is to extract SysDVR into your Pi. Congrats, you made it through. You now have a Raspberry Pi Switch Lite dock. Now I'm using the TCP bridge mode right here, which uses the Wi-Fi, and you can launch it from your Pi terminal. Or if you want to get slightly fancy, you can program a USB to automatically launch SysDVR when you plug it in with UDEV rules. I'm sure you're all wondering, why don't I just use the USB mode? As you can see here, there's occasional audio and video skips. It does seem to be a Pi-specific problem since there's no problems on the PC. Do comment down below if you found a solution, or if you've tried it with other single-board computers that works much better than the Pi on USB. Now, I have to discuss some cons with this SysDVR, one of which is that not all games are actually supported. So how SysDVR actually works is that it uses the video capture feature on your Switch and streams it, which means resolution is locked at 720p and at only 30fps. And that also means that only games that support video capture will actually work. I'd say about 90% of the games do support video capture, but some popular ones like Super Smash Bros. Don't. A small nitpick, but because it uses the video capture, your Switch menu won't actually show up on TV. It's a small con, but you know, just squint a little bit at your tiny little light screen, should be fine. Now, because it's all streaming, there is a slight latency. It's absolutely playable for me, but you be the judge. Now, I haven't tested this extensively, but I have experienced some slowdowns, mainly on the menus. This is also the case on the PC version. For the majority of the games that I've tested, gameplay works perfectly fine. There's only one game that I've tested that lags in gameplay, and that's Breath of the Wild, unfortunately. But I'm sure you guys have beaten that, right? Do comment down below if you found any others. And a final little nitpick, how do I get rid of that mouse cursor? So, who is this for, really? When I bought the Switch Lite about a year ago, I thought, great, I'm gonna bring it everywhere. But you know, didn't expect most of us to be stuck home. I was really contemplating on getting the regular Switch, but knowing a new one might be announced in 2021, my cheap ass just couldn't. So thank God for SysDVR. With an extra $55 for a Pi 4, I have myself an almost regular Switch. Of course, plus $80 for the Joy-Cons. Plus, in some countries, you can barely get a regular Switch. You can buy the Lite much easier. But if you can buy the regular Switch, and you want to play it like a Switch, and don't care about the new upcoming console, then just get the regular one. Well, thanks guys. It's my first YouTube video. Please like and subscribe, and have a nice day.